Okay, so I want to do a quick example of how to do like the collision. This is kind of a classic problem in dynamics, is two marbles hitting each other on a table and finding their velocity after the impact. I've kind of made it a little easy for you because I've already broken the velocities out into the line of impact and the plane of contact. So again, we have the line of impact and the plane of contact. I've already broken the velocities out into their components along the LOI and the POC. If you're not given that, that's always the first step. Now, the thing that you always want to do is do the easy part first. So easy part first. And that's that the everything in the plane of contact direction, the 12 and the 8, so these guys, nothing's happening to them in this direction, so they stay the same before and after the impact. So if it's going 12 up before the impact, it's still going 12 up. If it's going 8 down, before the impact, it's still going 8 down after the impact. So actually, let's label this one. We need a couple more information thingies. So let's call that A and B. And I'll give you the mass of this one. We'll call this one 15 kilograms, and we'll call this one 20 kilograms. I realized I forgot to do that. All right, so let's say that our velocity of A, and let's call this y and x, it just for funsies. So in the y direction, initially, this is one of the reasons it gets annoying. I don't like to say that V sub A sub I. So I'm just going to call it A in the Y direction, one. So like A1Y. It's because they're all going to be V's, I guess is where I'm going with this. So I've got a kitty helping me. V1A. Nope, I just said I wasn't going to do that. Let's try this. A1Y. There we go. A1Y is going to be equal to A 2y. And B1y is going to be equal to B2y. And so that one's going to be equal to negative 8. And this one is going to be equal to positive 12. So you like if this is a 12-point problem, you've already got like at least 2 points. Then we're going to do conservation of momentum in the x direction. All right, and so that's a little bit harder. But the idea is we have our initial, oh, I'll write it this way. I'll write it with real letters. So for the system, actually, let me emphasize that. For the system. For the system. Okay, so for the entire system, I have initial like mass of A times the velocity of A, what was I calling the velocity of A? I'm doing that to be easier and now it's less easy. A1x plus the mass of B times the velocity of B1 in the x direction. There are no external forces on the system. If we assume that this is on a flat plane, there's no external forces, so there's no external forces. And so then that has to equal m. A2x plus MB, B2x. Okay, so we've actually got a lot of these. So again, as a reminder, this is because no external force on the system. And eventually, I mean, no matter what, you can always make the system large enough that there are no external forces. You might not get any information, any interesting information about it, but it's a way to get started. All right, so the mass of A was what, like 15? And its initial velocity in that direction was 6, and then the other one is negative 5. So 6, and then the mass of B is 20, and its direction is negative 5. Come here. And that's equal to 15 times some unknown A2x, and 20 times some unknown B2x. So I can simplify that and get 3 A2x plus 4 B2x is equal to negative 2. Yay! Okay, so once I've applied conservation of momentum for the system, then I can apply elasticity. Apply elasticity. That's just fun to say and fun to write. Okay, so remember that the elasticity equation tells us that we have B2 minus A2 over A1 minus B1. And you might be like, but I was told that it's A2 minus B2 over B1 minus A1. And then you go, oh, wait, if I factor out a negative, the top and the bottom, they're both equivalent. So it doesn't matter. And since we have chosen this to be, the elasticity happens in the x direction because that's along the line of impact, that's where we would apply it. So I've got 0.4 is equal to B2x minus A2x over A1, which was 6, and B1, which was negative 5. So I've basically got that B2x minus A2x, because that's equal to positive 11, is equal to 7.7. So actually from here, I can just take these two here and solve them. Okay, and I'm trying to do more of the physics and less of the math. So let's just assume if you're solving a problem like this, you can solve two equations and two unknowns. So you'll end up with A2x is equal to negative 4.69, and that B2x is equal to 3.01. Now, if they're asking for the components of velocity, then you're actually done because you've got the x and y components of each. If they're asking for the magnitude, or if these are in fact labeled as x and y axes, you can be like, okay, so the velocity of A, for example, 2, would be given by negative 4.69 in the x direction and negative 8 in the y direction. And if you kind of look at it and you think, okay, so it's kind of coming in like this, it's going to pop back off like that. So at least the signs on the answers make sense. And if it was asking you for magnitude, you know, you could do square root of the sum of the squares. And the same thing for VB2, you could break that out and say, okay, so in the x direction, it's 3.01 I hat and 12 J hat. So again, it's kind of coming in like this and it's popping out that way. So yeah, both of the numbers are positive. So that kind of makes sense. And the, just to make sure that you've got it, the magnitude of this before the impact should be higher than the magnitude after because you're losing something in that coefficient of restitution. So let's just actually confirm that. I think that's a 3.45, but I'm just going to do this. So yeah, so we could say that the velocity of, ooh, why am I still in that color? So the velocity of A before the impact, the magnitude of the velocity, I guess, is 10. The magnitude of velocity A after the impact should be smaller. It shouldn't get faster after it loses loses stuff. Plus 64. Yeah, so it's 9.27. And the other one should do the same thing. Let's just do that just to make sure. So that was 5, 12, 13. So that's 13. VB2 would be the square root of 3.01 and 144. So yeah, 12.4. So as you can see, both of these ended up getting shorter or slower after impact. So that's another way to kind of do a dummy test and see if your answers even make sense. If they end up going faster, you definitely know you dropped a negative somewhere. But again, it's all about just separating it out. Separating it out into the plane of contact, the line of impact, the X and the Y components, recognizing what does change, recognizing what doesn't change. And once you kind of get the hang of it, it's a pretty straightforward process. It's just, you know, getting used to it.